mantra itinu kamayamanaha. So this is the gati, this is the fate of a person who functions in life with various kama or the desires. And thus driven by the desires, he performs actions only to come back to with new desires to fulfill those desires, and that is how that kama karma, that is presented here as the very cause of the bandha or the bondage. And then again, page as the next one, sayatrayam atma analpam neti. That was earlier, in fact, 1178. This is the description of the death. Sayatrayam atma avalyam neti, or analpam neti, sammohayam neti. So when he dies, or is dying, he becomes unconscious. The body becomes extremely weak, he becomes unconscious. Asa enamete prana abhisamayanti. So this is a description of death. So all of that in the long description was here. The idea is that bondage has been described in great detail by mantra as well as brahmana. So mantra brahmana abhyam bandhamokshav sahetako abhetav. By mantra and brahmana, both the bondage and liberation have been stated along with their causes. So the tika says, so tadeva sakta sahakarmane dityadi mantrena, so yatrayam atma anhalpamne dityadi brahmane nacha, kama adi hetu sahita. So kama is presented ultimately as the hetu, the cause of the bondage. Of course, kama means ignorance, but kama, desire is the first manifestation of ignorance, and therefore desire is presented as the cause for the bondage. Kamadi hetu sahitah bandha mumukshana hetvena abhita. Why was this bondage described in such great detail? Mumukshana hetvena. For the mumukshu, it must be given up. So the bondage also is described in great detail so that mumukshu knows what pain is involved, what pain is involved when he leaves a certain kind of life, and how it must be given up. Nida sarve pramuchyante, page 1231. Kama yasya hridishtaha asamartyo mrito bhavati atra brahma samasnate, etc. So ityadi mantrena, so by this mantra, so first brahmana and then mantra. So since Brahmacharya says mantra brahmana abhyam, therefore this Tippanikara presents mantra first and brahmana later. So mantra comes later, brahmana comes first. But anyway, so then jada sarve pramuchyante, etc. So kama, when he becomes free from all the kamanas residing in his heart, then the one who thought himself immortal becomes immortal, and here itself becomes identified with Brahma. So this is liberation. Yatha akamayamanaha, we just read that mantra, you know, page 1212. Yaha akamaha, nishkamaha, aptakamaha, atmakamaha, dasya pranaha utkramanti, brahma ivasan, brahma apyeti. Asa akamayam, so this is itinu kamayamanaha. So that is the gati of a person, desiring person. Asa akamayamanaha, so one who is no more prompted by kamanas or desires, because akamaha, free from desires. Why nishkamaha? The kamanas have gone away. Why is it so? Aptakamaha, because all his desires are fulfilled. How is it so? Atmakamaha, because he appreciates everything as atma. And therefore, all objects of desire have reduced to Atma. And Atma is ever, always nitya prapta, therefore, apta kama. Therefore, there is no scope for the kamanas to remain in him, therefore, nishkama. And therefore, he has become free from kama, so akama. So, ityadi brahmanena cha, teshameva apekshatvena samyagdihetukaha mokshaha abhihitaha. And therefore, so this is that the one who becomes free from the kamana, he is the one who becomes liberated. So again, Moksha is presented as that which is to be acquired by becoming free from the kamana. To teshameva apekshatvena samyagdhi hetukaha moksha. So what is the hetu for moksha? Samyagdhi. Samyagdhi hetukaha. So moksha, the hetu, the cause or the reason for the moksha is samyagdhi, is the proper knowledge, is the right knowledge. So of course ignorance is the hetu for the bondage, and knowledge, the true knowledge of the truth, becomes the hetu for the liberation. So mantra brahmana abhyam bandha mokshau sahetu ko abhetau. Then Vyasakara said, shloka ischa punaha. Here. Shloka ischa punaha moksha swarupam vistarena pratipaditam. Punaha punasya tat swarupam shloka hi viprapanchadam. Later on, all the shloka that we have been studying here, so shloka ischa punaha moksha swarupam vistarena pratipaditam akamayamanah. Subsequently, all the mantras that have been coming, they have described in great detail the nature of moksha or liberation. This is vritta sankirtanam. This is what has gone by so far, that bondage and liberation both have been described along with their causes by mantra and brahmana. And Brahman and mantra, and then subsequently shlokas again elaborately describe this, the nature of moksha. Then Anandika says, Uttar Kandika Tatparimaha. Now the Kandika that is following, the 22nd. So how is it connected with what has gone by? Tatparimaha, the purport of this Kandika is being stated now. Vyasakara said, Evam etasmin Atmvishaye sarvo vedo yatha upayukto bhavati. Even in this manner, etasmin atmvishaye. In this atmvishaya, with reference to atma, says footnote 1 on that page 1270, atma shabda gochare pratyag abhinne brahmani ityartha. Atmvishaye atma shabda gochare pratyag abhinne brahmani. So how the entire Veda, so upayukta bhavati, viniyukta bhavati, how the whole Veda has its application. The whole Veda has its application merely in Atma, that is Brahma. Atma shabda gochare pratyaga bhinne brahmane. So that which is gochara, that which becomes the very subject, or that which is indicated by the word Atma, is nothing but Brahman, that is non-different from one's own self. So in Brahman that is non-different from one's own self, in that Brahman alone, for the Brahman alone, the whole Veda has its application. So etasmin atmavishaye sarvavedo yatha upayakto bhavati. So how the whole Veda has its application in Atma alone, that is none other than, that is non-separate from Brahman. Tat upayuktatvam, that upayogita, so that application. Tatha vaktavyamidhi. So, it has to be stated how the entire Veda is meant for directly or indirectly enabling the person to know the Atma, to become liberated. So, moksha is the real prayojanam, the purport or purpose of the Vedas, and that moksha can be attained by self-knowledge. So, samyakdhi, by the knowledge of the self as it is. Therefore, the entire Veda has only one thing to do, and that is to enable this person to be liberated, to help him gain the knowledge by revealing the truth that what is taken to be I is none other than Brahma. So this is where the entire Veda has its application, and that is what this Kandika also wants to show. So this 22nd Kandika also wants to show how the entire Veda is devoted to revealing the identity between Atma and Brahma, the knowledge of which is a means of moksha. So, tattatha vaktavyam iti tadartha. So, on the page 1271, tadartha. Brahmatmani sarvasya vedasya vinyoga pradashanartha iti avata. Brahmatmani sarvasya vedasya vinyoga pradarshanartha. That the entire Veda entire Veda has its application in Brahmatma, in Brahman, which is the Atma. So that is where the entire Veda has its application, to show that is the purpose of this Kandika. So this next passage is to show that. So let us read that Kandika now, perhaps. Begins from page 1269. Sava esha mahanaja atma yoyam vijnanamayah praneshu esha antarhruday akashah tasmin chete sarvasya vashi sarvasya ishanah sarvasya adhipatihi. Sana sadhuna karmana bhuyan no eva asadhuna kaniya. Esha sarveshvara esha bhutadhipatihi esha bhutapalah esha setur vidharanah esha amlokanam asambhedaya tametam vedanu vachanena brahmana vividishanti yajnena danena tapasa anashakena etameva viditva mundirbhavati etameva pravrajana lokamichyantah pravrajanti. Etadhasmavai tatpurve vidvamsah prajamna kamayante kim prajya karishyamah yeshamnah ayam atma ayam lokaiti dehasma patreshanayascha vitteshanayascha lokeshanayascha vithaya athaviksha charyan charande yaheva putraishana savitteshana yavitteshana sa lokeshana uvehyete eshana eva bhavatah sayesha neti neti atma agruhyo nahi gruhyate ashiryo nahi shiryate asango nahi sajyate asito navyathate narishyate etam haiva etena taratayate atah papam karavamiti atah kalyanam karavamiti uvehu haiva esha ete tarati nainam krita krite tapatah. So perhaps one of the most famous passages, that is Bhashyakara quotes most often from this passage some sections of it. Sava esha mahan ajah atma. So saha, that, esha, this itself shows identity between saha and esha. Saha, as Vashaka will explain, refers to something that is remote, to remind us of something that is already stated earlier. Esha refers to something that is immediate, so being stated, or has been stated immediately, right now, just earlier. महान अजह आत्मा योयम विज्ञानमय है। दिस महान अजह आत्मा इज आत्मा जस्ट रिफर्ड इन द प्रीवियस खंडिका दैट महान द ग्रेट अजह सो इन्फिनिट बर्थलेस आत्मा द सेल्फ विच इज जस्ट डिस्क्राइब्ड इन द प्रीवियस मंत्र देन योयम विज्ञानमय प्राणेशु वेल ऑफ कोर्स दैट वाज व्हाट वाज डिस्क्राइब्ड अर्लियर सो योयम विज्ञानमय प्राणेशु So that which obtains among the pranas, among the sense organs, vijnanamaya, identified with vijnanam. So the atma, that is of nature of consciousness, and identified with the intellect, and the one atma that obtains in the midst of the pranas, in the midst of the sense organs. Yesha antarudaya akasha tasmin she, that even comes from ajata shatru. So brahmana. Yesha antarudaya akasha. So the akasha space that obtains within the heart, this great infinite atma obtains the in the space that obtains within the heart. Yeshah antarudaye akashah. Tasmin shete, that is where he obtains, that is where he abides. The word akasha will be interpreted by Bhashyakar in two ways.
December 22, 1999.
सवाएश महानज आत्मा योयम विज्ञानमय प्राणेशु येषोऽन्तर्हृदय आकाश है तस्मिन् शेते सर्वस्य वशे सर्वस्येषानः सर्वस्याधिपतिः सनसाधुना कर्मणा भूयान् नो एवा साधुना कनीयान् एष सर्वेश्वरः एष भूताधिपतिः एष भूतपालः एष सेतुर्विधरणः एषां लोकानां संभेदाय समेतं वेदानुवचनेन ब्राह्मणा विविदिशन्ते यज्ञेन दानेन तपसा नाशकेन एतमेव विदित्वा मुनिर्भवति एतमेव प्रव्राजनो लोकमिच्छन्तः प्रव्रजन्ति एतद्भस्म वै तत्पूर्वे विद्वांसः प्रजान्न कामयन्ते किं प्रजया करिष्यामो येषां नोऽयमात्मायं लोक इति देहस्मपुत्रैषणायाश्च वित्तैषणायाश्च लोकैषणायाश्च व्युत्थाय अथ भिक्षाचर्यं चरन्ति या ह्येव पुत्रैषणा सा वित्तैषणा या वित्तैषणा सा लोकैषणा उभे ह्येते एषणे एव भवतः स एषणेति नेत्यात्मा अगृह्यो न हि गृह्यते अशीर्यो न हि शीर्यते असंगो न हि सज्यते असितो न व्यसते न रिष्यते एतम् है वैतेन तरत इति अतः पापमकरवमिति अतः कल्याणमकरवमिति उहे उहे वै है वैश एते तरते नैनं कृताकृते तपतः
सहेतुकौ बंधमोक्षौ अभिहितौ मंत्र ब्राह्मणाभ्याम वाय मंत्र एंड ब्राह्मण सहेतुकौ अलोंग विद हेतु बंधमोक्षौ अभिहितौ Thus, this fourth chapter has told us about the bondage and liberation, along with the hetu, along with the causes, that the bondage is due to ignorance and the self-knowledge is the means for moksha. Sloka ischa punaha moksha swarupam vistarena pratipaditam. And subsequently, a number of slokas have been quoted, by which moksha swarupam vistarena pratipaditam, the nature of moksha liberation has been delineated elaborately. एवं एतस्मिन् आत्मविषये सर्ववेदो यथा उपयुक्तो भवति दस एतस्मिन् आत्मविषये हाउ इन दिस विषय द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ द सेल्फ सर्ववेदो यथा उपयुक्तो भवति हाउ द एंटायर वेदा हैज इट्स एप्लीकेशन हाउ द एंटायर वेदा इज बेसिकली डिवोटेड टू रिवीलिंग द आत्म तत्व द नेचर ऑफ द सेल्फ तत् तथा वक्तव्यम दैट हैज टू बी स्टेटेड So Shruti feels that it must be stated that the entire Veda is devoted to only Atma or Brahmatma. Tametam Vedanu Vachanena Brahmanaha Vividishyanti. This is what is meant. So it is that statement which actually clearly states how the entire Veda, that is Samhita and the Brahmana, Aranyaka, Upanishad, all of these are directly or indirectly only revealing the Atma one way or the other. So that must be stated someplace. Tadarthayam kandika arabhyade. And for that purpose, tadartha, brahmatmani sarasvedasya vinyoga pradashanartha. How the entire Veda has its application in brahmatma to show that is the purpose of this kandika. All right, that is okay. That Vividisha Homes.
December 21, 1999.
So renunciates become wandering monks. So first they discover renunciation, as a result they become the wandering monks. Etat dasmavai tat purve vidvamsa prajamna kamayante. The purve vidvamsa, the ancient knowers. Etat dasmavai, it is said, prajamna kamayante did not desire the progeny. So it is for this reason indeed that the earlier sages or earlier wise or discriminating people did not desire progeny. Where praja also means na karmana na prajaya dhanena, praja karma dhana, for all this, vitteshana, lokeshana, putreshana, all of these did not desire. Why? Kim praja karishyamaha? What use do we have with the praja and karma and vitta? Ye shamna, ayam atma, ayam loka. Those of us who desire this atma loka. So what use do we have for all these means, which are so praja, dhanam and all this karma, which are the means of anatma loka? What use do we have with karma, praja and dhanam, which are the means of anatma loka? What use do we have? And therefore, they did not desire the praja, the progeny, in any of these things. देहस्म पुत्रेषणायाश्च वित्तेषणायाश्च लोकेषणायाश्च वित्ताय अथ भिक्षाचर्यम् चरन्ति. So with this discrimination, this viveka, knowing that the atma is beyond hunger and thirst and pleasure and pain and grief and delusion and death and old age, that knowing that very thing itself, they become free from all the ishanas. देहस्म पुत्रेषणायाश्च from the ishana for the progeny, vittaishanayasa, from the ishana, from the wealth. And vitta here includes both the manasam vittam and daivam vittam. So manasam vittam becomes the means for the karma, daivam vittam becomes the means for upasana. Lokaishanayasa, and become through ishana, the craving for the worlds, this world, the intermediate world, and the heavens, which are all the anatma loka. Vyuttaya, arising from that, becoming free from those ashanas or cravings, Atha bhikshacharyam charanti. They take to the life of mendicants, which means that they become renunciates. Yahya putreshana, savitreshana, all this has come earlier. This is a repetition of the same passage. So that which is eshana for the putra is indeed the eshana for the vitra. Inasmuch as both of these are the ish of the nature of sadhana. So putrena ayam lokah jayyah and karmana pitralokah vidya devalokah. So thus this putra, karma and the vidya, all of them become the sadhana for attainment of different lokas. So really lokeshana is only eshana. A person wants to go to swarga or some place, and for that he then, in order to go to swarga, he must perform the upasanas, karma, etc. Therefore he desires the karma. Therefore he desires the vitta. Therefore he desires the son also, or the wife. And so, that's how the desire for the wife ultimately was only for the son, and so that he could perform the karma. And son, so that he could assure himself this world. And karma, so that he could assure the pitraloka. And upasana, so that he could assure the swargaloka. This is how. That is how yaheva putreshana, savitteshana. So that which is called the desire for the progeny is indeed the desire for the wealth, because both of them are the nature of sadhana. Yavitteshana, salokeshana. Ultimately, this putreshana is vitteshana. So both vitteshana and putreshana are meant for loka only. Therefore, the sadhana and sadhya also are not different. Therefore, it is said, yaputra vitteshana, salokeshana. Vitteshana includes putreshana also, both of them are for loka. Uvehyete eshane bhavataha. So uvehyete eva eshane bhavataha. Only these two, sadhana and sadhya, they become the eshanas. In short, the desires in our life are for sadhana and sadhya. That's all. Then again, repeating the passage earlier, Seshanetineti atma. Agruhyo nahi gruhyate, asiryo nahi shiryate, asango nahi sajyate, asitonam vyathate, narishyate. And so, esha da adesha, the upadesha for the atma is neti neti. This self that is such has been described as not this, not this. It is agruhyo nahi gruhyate, it is imperceptible. Never cannot be perceived. Ashiryo nahi shiryate. And so, it is unshrinking, it says, not perceived. Unshrinking, for it does not shrink. Asango nahi sajyate, unattached, for it is not attached. And then, asito na vyasate, na rishyate. Untrammeled, it does not suffer, nor perish. And therefore, etam huyeva, etam uhe haeva ete natarata haiti. And therefore, it is quite appropriate that the knower of this Atma, he is never tarati, he is never overtaken by these two thoughts. So these two thoughts never overtake him. Etam, etam means this wise person. Ete, these two, natarataha. These two meaning these two thoughts never tarataha, they never overtake this wise person. Which two thoughts? Ataha, papam akaramiti. Ataha, for this reason I perform papa. Ataha, kalyanam akaramiti. For this reason I did punya. These two thoughts do not bother him. In short, he transcends the pain that comes from these two thoughts. Kimaham sadhuna karavam, kimaham papam akaravam. That's even better. Because there is no regret for having done good things. But anyway, he becomes free from the idea of having done the good and the bad and the good, both the things. That's why he said, nayenam krita krute tapataha. And therefore, what he has done or what he is omitted to do, none of them afflict him. Ubehuevese esha ete tarate. Because he transcends, he goes beyond both of this punya and papa. That means he goes beyond the idea of kartratvam. Because one can take the credit for punya when there is sense of doership, or one can blame oneself for papa again when there is sense of doership. So by this knowledge, one becomes free from the sense of doership, and therefore becomes free from the idea of one having done the punya and papa, and therefore the harsh and the shoka, which these two thoughts bring about, he becomes totally free from this, the attack of what we call the pairs of opposites. Ashariram vavasantam na priya priya spruśataha. So priya and apriya, none of them actually afflict him. One who has discovered himself as unembodied. So this is a long passage here. And here several footnotes are also there, which we may take a look at them right now. See on the page 1269, footnote number 1.
अथ विविदिषावाक्येन ब्रह्मात्मनि सरस्वेदस्य विनियोगकथनार्थं तावदस्मिन् अध्याये उक्तं सफलमात्मज्ञानं सवायेषेति इत्यादि असंभेदायेत्य अन्तेन अनुवदति.
सो विविदिष दिस पैसेज इज कॉल्ड विविदिषावाक्यम. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज विविदिषा. सो अथ विविदिषावाक्येन, सो बाय दिस पैसेज विच टॉक्स अबाउट विविदिषा, विच पर्टेन्स टू विविदिषा, ब्राह्मणः विविदिषन्ति. What does this vakya, what does this passage do? Brahmatmani sarvasya vedasya viniyogakathanartham.
So that vividisha vakya, as we just saw, how it says that the entire Veda has its application, the purpose of the entire Veda is nothing but in Brahmatma. So sarvasya vedasya brahmatmani viniyogakathanartham.
The entire Veda has its application. So Veda has its fulfillment, as a matter of fact, in describing or in revealing the identity of Brahma and Atma. So Brahma is the subject matter of the entire Veda. Vinyokathanartham tavat asmin adhyaye uktam. In order to say that, what is first being said? Asmin adhyaye, in this fourth adhyaya, uktam saphalam atmajnanam.
So this fourth chapter of the nature of the dialogue between King Janaka and Sri Yajnavalkya has stated atmajnanam, the self-knowledge, saphalam, along with its results, moksha.
So this is very elaborately delineated, the self-knowledge along with its result, that is the moksha.
Asmin adhyaya uktam. So that which is stated in this chapter is also reiterated. In short, this passage first reiterates what has been stated in this chapter, namely the self-knowledge and the result of self-knowledge, which is moksha.
That's what this tika says. Uktam saphalam atmajnanam sava eshah. That is the beginning from this passage. Iti asambheda iti antena, and that asambheda was on this on the page 1272. Esha setuhu vidharanah esham lokanam asambhedaya.
So this is a bank which serves as a boundary to keep these different worlds apart from each other. Up to that point
is etena anuvadati. So beginning of sava esha, up to that is the reiteration, a recapitulation of what has been stated already in this fourth chapter, namely the self-knowledge and the result of self-knowledge, which is moksha.
Anuvadati sava iti.
Then the tika explains, saha jyotir brahmanokto jivaha.
So katam atma yajnivalkya, which one of this is the atma? Yoyam vijnanamah praneshu antarudaye jyotihi.
So saha jyotir brahmanokto jivaha.
The main discussion in jyotir brahmana was pertaining to atma.
Saha, that is vyavahita. So that was remote.
Esha atra avyavahita okta, what has been just stated. Virajah prakashat aja atma mahan dhruvah.
Atavivita uktaha paramatma.
So this is paramatma. That jivatma, sava esha, saha refers to jivatma, esha, this refers to paramatma.
that jiva who is this paramatma, that's what it means. And that's how merely by this pronoun savai esha, the Upanishad in fact reveals the identity between the jiva and paramatma. Then the Deeka continues. Eva muktam aikyam prakati kartum, that saha and esha, by putting them in samadhikaranya, there is an identity between that which is referred to by saha and that which is referred to by esha. Eva muktam aikyam, so aikya, the identity that has been thus stated here by placing them in samadhikaranya, saha and esha. It should have been enough. But then this passage clarifies what is saha and what is esha. So mahan as atma refers to esha, and yoyam vijnanamaya praneshu refers to saha. So says here, esha shabdena virajah ityadi uktaha paramatma abhihitaha. So by this word esha, by this pronoun esha shabdena virajah para akashat aja atma mahan dhruvah ityadi ukta paramatma abhihitah. So by the word esha is meant, is stated paramatma. Iti dyodaitam tastham visheshana dvayamah, that esha refers to paramatma, which has been described in the previous passage. And to clarify that, even this passage also Upanishad uses maha ajah. So mahan and ajah, so two visheshanas are from the previous passage are reiterated here to make sure that the word esha, the pronoun esha, refers to paramatma of that passage. So paramatma abhita iti dyota idam tatsam visheshana dvamaha mahan ajah atma iti. Sa shabdena jyotir brahmanokto jiva abhitaiti, and that by the word saha is meant the jiva that was referred to in the jyotir brahmana. To clarify that, iti dyotaitum tastham visheshana dvayamaha, so two visheshanas from that passage are also reiterated here, repeated, yoyam vijnanamaya praneshvidi. Then tika says, ubhayoho aikya lakshana vakyartha samadhikaranya abhita iti dyotaitum atrevoktamaha yaha iti. Uvayoho aikya lakshana vakyatha. Vakya is what? Tattvamasi. Vakyatha is the identity between tad and tam, tvam. So tvam is a jivatma jyotir brahmanoktaha. Tat is the paramatma that is avyahita uktaha, has been stated just now. Uvayoho aikya lakshana vakyatha. So mahavakya, which is of the nature of, which reveals the identity between tat and tvam, or jiva and paramatma, samadhikaranya abhihitaha iti. So this sava esha, which is samadhikaranya, that in fact reveals the identity between jiva and paramatma, iti dyodaitum, that this sava esha is meant to reveal the identity between tat and tvam pada, which is vakyatha, mahavakyatha. Iti dyodaitam, in order to clarify that, atreva uktamaha. Yaha iti. Yaha, esha, antarudaya, akasha, tasmin shete. So Vashyakara will explain the word akasha in two ways, as the space in the heart, as well as akasha means paramatma. That this esha, this jivatma shete, at the time of deep sleep, this jivatma actually remains in paramatma, which is the akasha. So that is how the identity there again between jiva and paramatma is revealed by this statement here that comes from the earlier one. Siddhi Dyotam Atreva Uktamaha. And so, what has been stated, he is stated here again. So, yaisha antarudaya akasha, the Tika explains. Samprasada samaye, yaisha antarudaya akasha paramatmakya buddhyadi ashrayava tasmin karmena vijnanamah shete eki bhuto vartate buddhyadi sakshirupena vartate ityartha. So, yesha antarudaya akasha tasmin shete. What does it mean? Samprasada samaye. At the time of deep sleep or profound sleep, yesha antarudaya akasha. So, antarudaya, within the heart, ya akasha, the space that obtains within the heart. What is the meaning of that space? What obtains is the space within the heart? Paramatma kya, so that which is known as Paramatma. So, akasha is Paramatma. Or buddhyadi ashrayava, or the space really which is where the mind is said to abide. So the space within the heart is a location for the mind. So thus word akasha can be understood in two ways, either as paramatma or as a space within the heart. In which case it becomes what? Buddhyashraya, the ashraya, the abode of the antahkarana. Tasmin shete, that is where this vijnanam hai shrete, this jivatma, he dwells there. Tasmin kramena vijnanam hai shrete, shrete means eki bhutovas. So he sleeps there, he lies there. That is what? Eki bhutovartade. So he becomes one with that. That is what? Tasmin paramatmani eki bhuto vartate, tasmin paramatmani esha vijnanamah shete eki bhuto vartate. In short, in the state of deep sleep, this jivatma becomes one with paramatma. Thus revealing the identity between jivatma and paramatma. Or, if you want to say that, the space means the space where the antahkarana is, that is the physical space within the heart, then buddhyadi. Then what do you mean by this jivatma remaining there, dwelling there? Buddhyadi sakshirupena vavartate. Or this paramatma, jivatma remains in the space within the heart as a very sakshi, as a very witness of the buddhi, as a very witness of the antahkarana. Ityartha. So thus this footnote number 1 nicely explains this first portion of this passage here. Then another footnote comes on the page 1272, I think. Tametam vedana vachanena evam anuvada prayojane bhutam vedamini yogamaha. So, esha setuhu vidharanaha esham lokanam asambhedaya. Up to that is nothing but reiteration of what has been stated in this chapter. So, in this text, so far what has been stated, namely Brahmatma, the identity between the two, is what has been stated in this passage up to Esha Sesham Lokanam Asambhedaya. So footnote 1 says, Evam Anuvada Prayojane Bhutam Veda Viniyogamaha. Anuvada Prayojane Bhutam. What is the Prayojana? What is the purpose of this Anuvada? So what is the purpose why this passage reiterated what all has been stated in the fourth chapter? So up to this point, this is restatement, reiteration. What's the prayojan? What's the purpose of that? So prayojani bhutam veda viniyogam. To say that the entire Veda has its application in Brahmatma, what's the purpose of repeating, reiterating all this? And that viniyoga, the actual application of the entire Veda in Brahma is now being stated specifically. Tametam vedanu vachanena brahmana vivadishanti. Tametam మంత్రోక్త విశేషణకం ఔపనిషదం పురుషం. సో తమ్ అండ్ ఏతమ్ అగైన్ తమ్ మంత్రోక్త విశేషణకం ఔపనిషదం పురుషం. సో దట్ పురుష అది పరమాత్మ మంత్రోక్త విశేషణకం ఆ విశేషణ విచ్ డిస్క్రైబ్ మంత్ర విరజ పరాకాశాత్ అజ ఆత్మా మహాన్ ధ్రువ అండ్ అదర్స్ సో దట్ ఔపనిషదం పురుషం. సో ది పురుష దట్ ఈస్ ఎర్లియర్ యునో విచ్ ఇస్ ది విచ్ ఇస్ రివీల్డ్ బై ఉపనిషద్ ఆర్ పురుష ఫర్ విచ్ ది ఉపనిషద్ ప్రమాణం పురుషం వేదానువచనేన నిత్య స్వాధ్యాయ లక్షణేన. సో వేదానువచనేన బై రిపీటింగ్ ది వేదాస్ ఎవ్రీడే అండ్ యజ్ఞేన దానేన తపసా అనాశకేన అంతఃకరణ శుద్ధి ద్వారా వివిధిషంతి. సో బ్రాహ్మణ సీక్ టు నో దిస్ ది బ్రహ్మన్ సీక్ టు నో ద బ్రహ్మన్ దట్ ఇస్ బ్రాహ్మణ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ వాంట్ టు క్రియేట్ దట్ జిజ్ఞాస వివిధిష that they want that the vividisha or the desire to know Brahman should be created within us. And for that desire to arise in the heart, they live a certain way of life, which is Vedana Vachanam, Yajna, Dana, Tapaha, etc. Nutu Vidanti. So then we have to look at it like this, Vedana Vachanena Vividishandi. వచనైన అంతఃకరణ శుద్ధి ద్వారా వివిధిషంతి దట్ వేదానువచనం నిత్య స్వాధ్యాయ లక్షణం. సో దాట్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఆఫ్ నేచర్ ఆఫ్ రిపీటింగ్ ది వేదాస్ ఎవ్రీ డే దాట్ బ్రింగ్స్ అబౌట్ అంతఃకరణ శుద్ధి అండ్ త్రూ దాట్ దే సీక్ టు నో దట్ ఈస్ వెన్ ది అంతఃకరణ బికమ్ శుద్ధ దెన్ దేర్ అరైజెస్ ఎ డిజైర్ ఫర్ నోయింగ్ బ్రహ్మ. సిమిలర్లీ యజ్ఞేన ఇత్యాది యజ్ఞేన వివిధిషంతి దానేన వివిధిషంతి తపసా వివిధిషంతి తపసా అనాశకేన వివిధిషంతి. యజ్ఞదాన తపఃకర్మ నత్యాజ్యం కార్యమేవ తత్ యజ్ఞోదానం తపస్సైవ పావనాని మనీషిణాం ఏతాన్యపి చ కర్మాణి సంగం త్యక్త్వా ఫలాని చ కర్తవ్యాని ఇతి మే పార్థ నిశ్చితం తముత్తమం. ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దట్ కమ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్. ఓకే దెన్ any footnotes subsequently. Yeah, page 1273, footnote number 1. Tapasa anashakena etameva viditva munirbhavati. Says, nanu vedena icchataha. In fact, vedena icchataha it should be. So, vividishanti. They desire to know. Suppose that desire to know arises, so what? Nanu veda icchatah kim syat. So suppose you gain the desire to know Brahman, so what happens? So Upanishad says, etame viditva munir bhavati. Knowing this, one becomes a muni, one becomes a sage. Then, ఏతమేవ ప్రవ్రాజనో లోకమిచ్చంద ప్రవ్రజంతి. ఫుడ్ నంబర్ టూ ప్రవ్రజంతి. యాక్చువల్లీ ప్రవ్రజంతి అపియర్స్ లైక్ ఓన్లీ ప్రెసెంట్ టెన్స్. సో స్టేటింగ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ప్రవ్రజంతి లోకమిచ్చంద డిజైరింగ్ దిస్ ఆత్మలోక ది రినన్సియేట్స్ టేక్ టు ద లైఫ్ ఆఫ్ వాండరింగ్ మంక్ బట్ సేస్ ప్రవ్రజంతి పంచమలకారేణ సన్యాస విధీయతే. జస్ట్ ఎస్ వ్యుత్థాయ భిక్షాచర్యం చరంతి. So that charanti was interpreted as chareyuhu, bhikshacharyam chareyuhu, that they must take to the life of bhikshacharya. So with a long discussion there, Vashyakara established that bhikshacharyam charanti is in fact a vidhivakya. So this is where, I mean, he was really committed to that, and therefore, that in fact Upanishads enjoy in sannyasa for the knowledge. And then alone, what is it, తస్మాత్ బ్రాహ్మణ పాండిత్యం నిర్విద్య బాల్య నితిష్టాసే బాల్యం చ పాండిత్య నిర్విద్య మునిర్భవతి అమౌనం మౌనం చ నిర్విద్య ఎట్సెట్రా దట్ కమ్స్ లేటర్. So only when sannyasa is taken, then alone panditya, that is shravanam, and then mananam, then nidhyasanam, then brahmanishtha are there. And therefore, that was interpreted as a statement for enjoining sannyasa. Here also. So pravrajanti is supposed to be panchama lakara, that's a late lakara. That's only employed in the Vedas. Sannyasa viriyate. And so in fact, pravrajanti is pravrajayuhu, whatever. So this is how they, in this is vidhi, that they must take the life of sannyasa. Agneha ashtakapalo bhavati yavata, whatever that means, you know. So agneha ashtakapalo. Eight kapalas, patras must be there in a particular yaga, must be there. Then footnote number 3. Itad dasmai vid tatpurve vidvamsa prayamna kamayante. It's for this reason that the earlier, it's for this reason that the ancient sages, it is said, did not desire the children of progeny. So the footnote number 300 page, 1273 says, pravrajanti iti sannyasa vidhiti itat katham nischedam shakyate. How do you say that pravrajanti seems to be a simply statement of some occurrence? How do you say that it's vidhi and enjoyment in sannyasa? Iti itat katham nischedam shakyate. How do you arrive at this conclusion, or how do you determine that? Iti ashankya tan nirnayakam tad arthavadamaham. Tan nirnayakam. It is not for no reason that we have come to this conclusion that pravrajanti is a statement of enjoyment. So what is that leads you to that conclusion? Or that ascertainment? That arthavadamaha. See, subsequent to follow the arthavada. Bhuta arthavada. Edad dasmahavai. Edad dasmahavai. Tat pura vidvamsa. Prajam na kamayante. Na kamayante sma. That the earlier sages also did not desire the progeny. That means they took the sannyasa. Otherwise you have to be there. You can't say, I'm a grahastha and I do not want progeny. I'm a grahastha and I don't want wealth. I'm grahastha and I don't want karma. It can't be. So when grahastha is there, whether you have progeny or not is a different thing. But not desiring. Not desiring wealth. You back and become a sannyasi, no? So grahastha ashram means this. Praja must be there and karma must be there and the vitta must be there, generally speaking. So that is how, but when they say purva vidvamsa prajam na kamayante, that they did not desire progeny, that means they did not desire progeny and wealth and karma and whatever, that means they became renunciates. Of course, vanaprastha ashram means no progeny, etc. That's a different ashrama. So, but grahastha ashrama. So, explaining that, etat dasmavai tat purve says, tad etat, there is an etat and there is a tat. Etat ha smavai tat. So, the tika says, tad etat, parivrajya spashtam karanam ha kilavai smaryate. Tad etat, that this karanam, the cause for parivrajyam, for taking the life of renunciate, this cause is smaryate, is brought to our notice, brought to our attention. Vidvamsa prajanna kamayante kim praja, thinking this kim praja karishyama, etc. So this is the preparation for the renunciation. That is all anuvada. It is the bhuta anuvada. Anuvada means reiteration of what happened. And therefore, we say that it is from that Upanishad says that to mean that in the present also, in the Vartaman also, those who become free from the desires must take the life of renunciation. Shesham bhashita avagantavyam. Okay. Again, next page, 1274. Footnote number 1. Kim praja karishyama ye shamnah ayam atma ayam lokaheti. So yah puttadi sadhya uchyate. So that which people desire through progeny, etc., is for us the Atmaloka. So whatever it is that they seek to achieve through Swarga and Pitruloka and whatever, is what we seek to achieve through the Atmaloka. Ishamna ayam atma ayam loka hai. Then next page, 1275, footnote 1 was, Tihasma putreshanayasya vittreshanayasya lokeshanayasya vitthaya. Te meaning pure brahmanaha, footnote number 2 there on the page 1275, tarhi te kim krutavantaha. Alright, when they said that, what use do we have for the progeny? When all we need is atmaloka. That karma, praja, vittam, all of these are the means of the anatmaloka. When we don't want anatmaloka, so those of us who want the atmaloka, what use do we have for the sadhana for the anatmaloka? Tarite kim krutavantaha? Then what did they do? Having thus stated, or having thus come to this conclusion, that what use do we have for all these eshanas or the means, what did they do? Tehasma ityadi tehasma. Putreshanayasya, Vittreshanayasya, Lokeshanayasya, Vithaya, Atha Vikshacharyam Charandi. All is anuvada. Vikshacharyam Charandi. Tathacha Uktarthavadha or Bhutarthavadha. Arthavada, restating something or describing something that happened in the past. Also for deriving from lesson in the present. That is the idea. Tathacha Uktarthavadeva Pravajantiti Asya Sanyasa Viditva Nishayakaha. So this whole anuvada is what leads us to conclusion that earlier Pravajanti, Pravrajanaha Pravrajanti is in fact a vidhi, is in fact an enjoyment of a sannyasa. Vidhimantarena Tasya Ananvayadati Bhavaha. Unless Pravrajanti is taken as a vidhi or enjoyment, this anuvada will not have any relevance at all. So, therefore, this anuvada leads us to the conclusion that Pravrajanti should mean Pravrajayuhu, it's a vidhi for sannyasa. The next page, 1276, footnote number 1. Saesha neti neti atma agruhyo nahi gruhyate, footnote number 1. Saesha ityadi narishyati diyantam nahi sajyate asito na vyasate narishyate narishyati idi antam. Shakalya brahma uktasakam, all of this comes from the Shakalya brahmana. यह सूत्राश्रय अंतर्यामिक अंतर्यामित्व कल्पनाधिष्ठान भूत है स परमात्मा एषः सैषः नेति नेति प्रत्यगात्मैव मूर्तामुद ब्राह्मणे नेति नेति देवं सकलोपाधि सिद्धेन निर्दिष्टः सो यह सूत्राश्रय अंतर्यामित्व कल्पनाधिष्ठान भूत है. So, Paramatma is antaryami. He becomes the inner indwelling, so antaryami. So, antasanyamayati, one remaining inside the inner controller. So, inner control also is a kalpana. To call Brahman as antaryami, so antaryami kalpana adhishthana bhuta sutra shayantara sutra. Hiranyagarbha is the one that supposedly is a samasti sukshimsharupayata chaitanyam. And therefore, Hiranyagarbha is the one that can be stated as dwelling in the hearts of all. And so, Sutrashraya and Hiranyagarbha also is ashraya ultimately in Chaitanya. So that Chaitanya, which is ashraya of the Hiranyagarbha, that is the Atma of all, is looked upon as the Antaryami, the inner dweller or the inner controller. So Antaryamitva Kalpana Adhishthana Bhutaha Sa Paramatma. So Paramatma. So was described as antaryami in the so eshate atma antaryami amrutah, that one sah paramatma esha pratyagatma eva So that Paramatma that was described in Antaryami, the inner controller, is indeed this Pratyegatma, the one's own self itself. Indeed,
Murta Murta Brahmane Neti Neti Devam Sakalopadhani Siddhena Nirdishtaha.
First Neti Neti came in the Murta Murta Brahmana. So Murta Murta Brahmane in the second chapter.
Neti Neti Devam Sakalopadhani Siddhena.
So neti, murtam neti, amurtam neti, in this manner, by negation of all the upadhis in Brahman, that Atma, or the Paramatma indeed, was in Nirdishta, was indicated there.
Okay, so that completes this passage. 77.
Tam huva eva aha. It is narishyati etam u ha eva. So many particles are there. U ha eva means indeed. Indeed, etam ete na tartaha.
These two do not overtake him. These two thoughts do not overtake him.
So, footnote 1, etadrupasya sarvaishana vinivrittasya kim syat.
So, the person who is thus become free from all vaishanas, what happens?
Ittadaha etam.
Uktarupam paramatmahutam atmavidam ityartha.
Etam means this one.
Uktarupam.
So, stated earlier, paramatmahutam atmavidam.
So, the knower of the Atma, who has become very paramatma,
That is what is referred to. This person is referred to as etam.
This one, the punya and the papa, the thoughts of punya and the papa do not overtake him.
Do not overwhelm him.
How? This wise person.
So, who has paramatma bhutam, who has become paramatma.
How? Atmavidam.
By knowing the atma, one has become paramatma.
By knowing the identity between atma and paramatma,
one who has become very paramatma, to that person, these two thoughts do not overtake him anymore.
Okay.
So we are on the page 1271.
Sutadarthayam kandika arabhyade.
Tadartha brahmatmani sarasvedasya vinyoga pradashanatha iti avadam.
To show how the entire Veda has its application or find its fulfillment in one subject matter, which is Brahma.
That is what this passage wants to show.
Now Anandagiri says, Nanu, Vividisha vakyena brahmatmani sarasvedasya vinyoga vakshate.
In fact, Vividisha vakya, which just follows the next page,
tametam vedanuvachanena brahmanaha vividishanti yajnas,
that vakya, which in fact shows the application of the entire Veda in Vividisha, in knowing Brahman, and therefore in Brahma.
So, nanu, footnote number two there, nanu iti, yadva, Savayityadina karmakandasya jnanakandasyeshatvam na uchyade tathate tadarthayam kandikayati ukti ayuktayati ashankyaha.
Oh, you can put it this way, yadva.
Sava means the passage.
Savayesha ajaha mahanatma.
So this passage beginning from Savai ityadina, that this particular statement of passage, karmakandasya jnanakanda sheshatvam.
So when we say that the entire Veda has its application only in Brahmatma, that means karmakanda also has application only in Brahma, but then really Brahma is primarily revealed in the jnanakanda.
So jnanakanda is devoted to Brahma, revealing Brahma.
But karmakanda is devoted to revealing karma. So how can you say that the entire Veda has its application in Brahma alone? Only when that karma also is meant for jnana. So only when it can be established that karma kanda also serves the purpose of jnana kanda, which reveals Brahma, and that's how we say the entire Veda has its application in revealing the Brahmatma, then it's okay. But says yadva sava ityadina karma kandasya jnana kanda sheshatvam. That karma kanda, jnana kanda shesha. That karma kanda is meant to serve the purpose of jnana kanda. No uchare. Somebody is just raising a question here. Why? Tathacha tadarthayam kandika iti upi ayukta. And therefore, to say that this kandika, or this passage, is meant to show how the entire Veda has its application in Brahma is not right. Iti ashankya tachaydi. That's interesting. And so, apparently the Tippanikara presents his own nano, the own connection of why Bhashyakara says tachya. So going back to Anangri, nano vividishavakyena brahmatmani sarvasya vedasya viniyogo vakshate. That this vakya tametam vedana vachanena brahmana vividishanti. That vakya very clearly states how the entire Veda is meant for Brahma. Tathacha tasmat praktanam vakyam kim artham. So, if you say that the purpose of this passage is to show how the entire Veda is devoted to Brahmatma, but that is very clearly stated by this passage, tametam vedanu vachanena. So, what is the need of the passage before then, Savayesh Mahanaja Atma and all the way up to Lokanava Sambheda, what purpose that passage, that portion of the passage serve? Tathacha tasmat praktanam vakyam, the vakya, the passage preceding that. Kimartham, what purpose did it serve? Iti ashankyaha tachaydi. So Bhashyakara says, what purpose that thing serves? Tachaydi. Tachya yatha asmin prapathake abhitam saprayojanam anudya atreva upayogah krishnasya vedasya kamyarashivarjitasya iti evamarthah उक्तार्थानुवाद है सवा एषः इत्यादि. तच्च यथा अस्मिन् प्रपाठके अभिहितम्, अस्मिन् प्रपाठके अस्मिन् अध्याये से दानगिरि, यथा अस्मिन् अध्याये सफलम् आत्मज्ञानमुक्तम् तथैव तत् अनुद्येति योजना. Yatha, just as asmin adhyaya, asmin prabhatake, asmin adhyaya. In adhyaya, in the fourth chapter, saphalam atma-jnanamuktam. The atma-jnanam, self-knowledge, been stated, saphalam, along with the result, namely moksha. Tathaiva tadanudya. So the passage before that, vividisha vakya, what does it do? It just reiterates or recapitulates all that is been stated in this fourth chapter, that is Atma-jnanam along with the phala. The whole thing is recapitulated in the passage up to that point. So, Bhagavan Vahashya, tachya, yatha asmin prapathake abhihitam saprayojanam. That means, yatha asmin prapathake saprayojanam Atma-jnanam abhihitam. That Atma-jnanam must be added. Atma-jnanam vahitam tad anudya. Anudya means doing the anuvada. So, anuvada means reiterating, recapitulating. Atraiva yathokte jnaneva, in that knowledge indeed, upyoga krishnasya vedasya. The entire Veda has its application to this knowledge of identity of Brahma and Atma. Upyoga Krishna Savedasya. Okay. So that the entire Veda is devoted to this knowledge alone is the purpose of reiterating, recapitulating. What all has been stated in the fourth chapter is recapitulated in these few statements here up to the Lokanam Asambheda, up to that statement. Katham yathokte jnane saro vedaha viniyoktum shakyade swarga kamadi vakyasa swargadaiva parivasana. How can you say that the entire Veda has application in moksha? Because swarga kamo yajeta, many statements definitely say that, pasu kamo yajeta, whatever it is, you know, and so, what is it, praja kamo yajeta. So people, person desiring of...
December 22, 1999.
Its application in Brahmatma, but how about the vakya beforehand? Saesha mahanajatma, all of that vakya that is stated here, savayesha, mahanajatma, yoyam vijnanamah praneshu, all of that. Esha untardaya akasha tasmin shete, sarvasya vashi, sarvasya ishanah, sarvasya adhipatihi, sara sadhana karmana bhuyanneva sadhana kaniyan, esha sarveshvaresha bhutadhipati, esha bhutapalha, esha setu vidharana, esham lokanam asambhedaya, all of this. So what is the purpose of this? Because specifically, that the whole Veda is devoted to Brahmatma is stated in this Tametam Vedan Vachanena. So tasmat praktanam vakyam kimartham. So what's the purpose of that vakya, passage before that? Tachya yatha asmin prapathake abhitam saprayojanam anudya. The whole Veda is devoted to moksha and bandha and moksha, or liberation from the bondage by the knowledge of Brahmatma. That even this fourth chapter also does that. Tachyetha asmin prapathake abhitam saprayojanam anudya. How this fourth chapter also is devoted to only revealing nature of bondage and liberation and revealing nature of Atma. Therefore, this passage also does the anuvada. It just reiterates or recapitulates. Saprayojanam atmajnanam safalam atmajnanam. So atmajnanam along with prayojanam the phala. Anudya, here, this passage reiterates or recapitulates this bondage and liberation, the self-knowledge along with the purpose in this chapter. So that this is so stated in the chapter. This chapter also is also being reiterated in this passage. Atreva upayoga krishna savedasya. So not only Vividisha Vakya says that, but by reiterating or recapitulating in the earlier section of the passage, what is stated in this fourth chapter also the Shruti wants to clearly say, Atreva upayoga krishna savedasya. How the entire Veda has this upayoga application here in Brahmatma itself. Kamirashi varjitasya. Katham yathokte jnane sarovedo viniyoktum shakyade swarga kamadi vakyasya swargadayo parivasanat. So you can prove perhaps that all the karma also ultimately has this parivasanam. Sarvam karma akhilam partha jnane parisamapyade. So that karma through the antahakana shuddhi leads to jnanam. But where the karma has a specific application, jyotishtomena swargakamo yajetan, this way, that this karma is meant for the one desiring swarga, and pashukama, and prajakama, and whatever. And so, there are many karma, the rituals, which are devoted specifically to serve the purpose of swarga, etc. So, those statements are very clear that this karma, the ritual, is meant for swarga. Then you cannot say that it is meant for Brahmatma, because Veda itself says swarga kama yajeta. So swarga kama adi vakyasa swarga adiva parivasanat. So that swarga kama vakya has its parivasanam in swarga and not in Brahmatma. Then how can you say that the entire Veda has its application in Brahmatma? Iti ashankya sanyoga prusaktva nyayam anadritya. In fact, by the sanyoga prusaktva nyaya, it can be shown how the entire Veda has its application in Brahmatma. But Bhashyakara ignores that, anadritya. Disregards that jnaya. Vishnasti kamyarashi varjitasya vedasya. That the Veda, excluding the section dealing with the kamya karma. Now, footnote number 3. Sanyoga prathaktvaidi. Ekasyatu uvayatve sanyoga prathaktvam iti Jaimini Sutra. Ekasya dravyasya ladasya. Two, however, uvayatve in both the applications. Sanyoga prathaktvam, because there is sanyoga prathaktvam. Sanyoga, the footnote says sanyoga vakyam. Tasya prasaktvam bhedaha. The idea is that when a given thing is mentioned in two different places, then one thing can serve two different purposes also. Normally we would think that any given thing in the world serves one purpose. But one thing can serve two different purposes if its application is mentioned in two different contexts. So that is what is meant by this statement, the sutra here. So tika says, sanyogaha vakyam tasya prasaktvam bhedaha ekasya ubhayasatve niyamakaha iti tadarthaha. Ekasya ubhayasatve. One thing can have its application in ubhaya, in two things, that is niyamakam, niyamakaha ityarthaha. So that if there are two different vakyas which show the application of one thing, then any one thing can have two separate applications. Explains. Yatha dadhna juhuyat iti phala asanyukta vakyena. Dadhna juhuyat, dadhna juhoti. Or dadhna juhuyat iti phala asanyukta vakyena. So this Agnihotradi karma is nitya karma. And nitya karma is that which is not supposed to give rest to a result. That's called nitya karma. Which is an obligatory duty, which are supposed to perform without expectation of any result. And the Mimamsakas would say that nitya and naimitya karma in fact do not produce any result. All they do is ward off any kind of the evil effects which may come. But in themselves, nitya, naimitya karma do not produce results. That is how niyatam kuru karmatvam, when it is said in Bhagavad Gita, niyatam is nityam. So here Arjuna, may you perform a nitya, naimitya karma. Give up this kamya karma, pratishiddha karma, all that stuff you give up. Do nitya, naimitya karma. And what is meant by nitya karma is where there is no expectation of any reward. The karma that you perform out of a sense of obligation, rather than out of an expectation of a reward, that means perform all your actions out of a sense of obligation. Because you are obliged. So you are running. So this is how very idea of nitya namiti karma is the karma yoga. Anyway, in this context, so dadhna juhuyat or dadhna juhodi, whatever, is where dadhi meaning curd. So it is said that the curd is mentioned as one of the dravyas to be offered in Agnihotra karma. Idi phala asayukta vakyena. There is no phala. So when you perform Agnihotra karma, theoretically there is no phala. Although Vedantists don't agree with that. But accepting the karma kanda, the Purva Mimamsa position on that when the dadhi or curd is used as one of the dravyas in Agnihotra, well, application of curd does not give rise to any phala. So, phala asanyukta vakyena. Kratvarthatvena vihitasyabhi dadna. So, dadhi or the curd is this vihitam, is enjoined to be used in kratu, in this daily ritual. Then, dadnendriya kamasya juhuyad. So this dadna juhoti or whatever, this dadna indriya kamasya juhuyat, that comes in Taittiriya Brahmana. So indriya kamasya juhuyat, indriya kama. So one who is desirous of the strength or the brilliance of the sense organs, indriyas. So that person must use the dadhi or curd. So the idea is that in that particular statement, if you use curd in performing that yaga, then there will be a specific result, inasmuch as there will be the strength or the brilliance of the sense organs. So in one case, the dadhi is mentioned with reference to no phala at all, with reference to nitya naimitik karma. In other case, dadhi is mentioned with reference to that which gives rise to a specific result. Iti anena phalaya vidharat purushatva vibhavati. So in one case, dadhi does not serve any purpose. In other case, dadhi serves a certain purpose. So in one case, it is used with nitya karma. In other case, uses anitya karma. So Puru Pakshi in the Puru Mimamsa says that this cannot be. That dadhi, one dravya or one substance called dadhi or curd, cannot have these two diverse applications, namely its application in nitya karma and anitya karma. Then this is being said. Then the sutra says, ekasya tu ubhayatve sanyoga prathaktvam, that even one dravya, in this case dadhi, can have two applications because sanyoga prathaktvam, those two vakyas are independent. They independently state the application of curd, and therefore a curd can have two independent applications, uses. Similarly, now that nyaya, now this jyotishtoma karma, which is said, jyotishtomena swarga kama yajeta, that one desires of swarga should perform jyotishtoma. However, here it says, tametam vedanuvachanena brahmanaha vividishanti yajnena danena tapasa. Yajnena also includes jyotishtomena. So according to this statement, that jyotishtoma karma, which is a part of yajna, produces vividishan. And elsewhere it says, jyotishtoma produces swarga. So can one jyotishtoma do these two diverse things? Puro Pakshi will say no. It can do only one thing. Siddhanta, so Mimamsa Siddhanta says, because these two vakyas are independent, so sanyoga prasaktvam, vakyasya prasaktvam, vakyasya bhedaha. This vakya is different, that vakya is different. Therefore, one jyotishtoma can have these two applications. So the tika says, tatha jyotishtoma adinam swargarthatvena vihitanam api. So thus, even though jyotishtoma and such other rituals are indeed enjoined for swarga as a means of swarga or heavens, tatha api yajnena ityadi vividisha vakyana. But this vakya versus yajnena vividishanti, danena vividishanti, tapasa vividishanti, anashakena vividishanti, vedanavachana vividishanti. Idi vakya vividisha sadhanatva api syadeva. Because yajnena is instrumental case, that means sadhana. And therefore, jyotishtomena swarga kama, that jyotishtoma is sadhana for swarga. Here jyotishtoma is sadhana for vividisha. So vividisha sadhanatma visyad eva iti bhava. Therefore, that jyotishtoma also can become means for vividisha. If you thus interpret this vakya, then the entire Veda, including this Madhusudan Sarvati, also discusses in the Bhagavad Gita at one point as to how every karma has its application in Brahmajnana ultimately. So any karma that is performed with Ishvarabha Buddhi, that very karma then leads to Antahakana Shuddhi, and thereby means of knowledge, and that is of moksha. So had Bhashyakara chosen to use his Sanyoga Prasaktva Nyaya, then Bhashyakara need not have said Kamya Rashi Varjitasya. Because what is called Kamya Rashi also, if performed without Kamana, would then give rise to Antahakana Shuddhi and would thus become a means of moksha. Therefore, Anandagiri says, sanyoga prasaktva nyayam anadratya. for whatever reason. Bhashyakara chooses to ignore that nyaya, the rule that has been arrived at in the Purva Mimamsa, and says, Kamirashi Varjitasya. So, entire Veda, excluding the Kamya Karma, has its application in Brahmatma. Iti evamartha uktartha anuvadha. Therefore, sava esha, or the uktartha anuvadha, is again to reiterate that the entire Veda has its application in Brahmatma. Ityadihi. Sava esha ityadihi. And the footnote said, asambhedaya iti avasana iti shesha, all the way, esham lokana asambhedaya, all the way, that is a statement which doesn't say anything new. It just says what has been stated in the past, in different places. But it recapitulates everything, meaning thereby that, see, the whole Veda has its application only in Brahmajnanam. Alright, now, going to next page, page 1273. Now, Vashyakara explains this vakya. Sava esha mahan ajatma yoyam vijnanamaya. So, what Vashyakara will say is that this is, it was said yesterday also, in the footnote we discussed, how Saha and Eshaha refer to two different entities. Saha refers to something that is remote, which was mentioned in the Jyotir Brahmana. Jyotir Brahmana means in reference to the Swayam Jyoti Atma. Eshaha refers to the mantra that just got concluded. Virajah para akashat aja atma mahan dhruvah. So that vakya. That is Eshaha. So thus, Savai Atma Yoyam Vijnanamaha Praneshu Esha Mahan Aja Atma Esha Mahan Aja. So Esha goes with Mahan Ajaha and Saha goes with Yoyam Vijnanamaha Praneshu. That is how Yoyam Vijnanamaha Praneshu, which refers to Jivatma, and Esha Mahan Aja Atma, which refers to Paramatma, the identity between both of them is shown here. That's how Bhashyakara will explain. So let's read the Bhashya. Where Anandagiri has anything to say. Uktasya safalasya atmajnanasya anuvadah iti yavat. Okay. Uktartha anuvadah uktasya safalasya atmajnanasya anuvadah. So atmajnanam along with the phalam, so is recapitulated here, iti yavat. Okay, so let us read the bhashya. Sahaiti Ukta Paramarshasaha. Again, that Saha comes from this Kandika. So we have this, all right. So it is this Saha. Okay. Sahaiti Ukta Paramarshasaha. The pronoun Saha is Paramarsha, to bring to our memory. Ukta, what has been stated. Footnote number 4. Uktaidi. Because Savai, Vai also is there. Then Uktaidi, Tena Paramrashtasyeva Smarakaha Vai Shabdo Drashtavya. Vai also generally shows prasiddhi or brings something to our attention. If Saha is said to be Ukta Paramrashata, if Saha is meant to bring to our attention what has been stated, then how about Vai? Vashyakara does not seem to have said anything about it, so the footnote says that anyway. Tena paramrashtasyeva smarakaha. So, saha paramrasha. So brings to our mind what was stated earlier and reminds us. So smarakaha vaishabdaha iti drashtavya. So vaishabdaha drashtavya. So vai also does that. Now, uktanam bhuyastve visheshram jnatam pruchyati. Uktanam bhuyastve. What is already stated is to be stated again. Visheshram jnatam pruchyati. Then to know which one is being referred to here. Saha. So, all right. If saha refers to something that is already stated, what is it? So, visheshram jnatam pruchyati. So many things are stated, mentioned. Ko savedi. Says Bhashyakara, kosau uktaha paramrushyade tam pratinirnishade yesha vijnanamayaha iti. Kosau uktaha paramrushyade. All right. So saha says uktaha. And then I guess why says paramrushyaha, whatever. So, which one is that which has been stated, which is brought to our mind here? So, by saha, what it is that is brought to our attention, or brought to our memory? Tam prati nirdishati, footnote 5. Tam prati, puruoktam paramarshayogyam visheshrupena pradashayati shruti hiti sheshaha. Thank God, Shruti herself says, what is meant by saha? Tam puruoktam paramarshayogyam. So what was stated earlier and which is paramarshayogyam? So which deserves to be referred to here, or which deserves to be brought to our attention? Visheshrupena pradashayati. Then the Shruti also specifically says what it is that is referred to by the pronoun saha. Iti sheshaha. And what is yesha vijnanamaha iti? So that's interesting. Yesha vijnanamaha, Bhashyakara says. So footnote 6 has something to say. Yesha iti, yesha shabdoyam, yoyam iti, ayam shabdasthane, tat pariyataya apadati bodhyam. It should be said yoyam actually. So yoyam vijnanamaha is what refers to saha. But Bhashyakara says, yesha vijnanamaha. It is not this Esha. Yesha is, in fact, that is why footnote number 6 says, yoyam iti ayam shabdasthane tat pariyataya apatitaha. Bhashyakara has inadvertently used the word Esha instead of word ayam. That's why, in fact, it should have been said, yoyam vijnanamaha iti. But Bhashyakara says, yesha vijnanamaha iti. So then, apologetically, the footnote says that what Esha shouldn't be understood as ayam. Ayam shabdasthane tat pariyayataya apa. Don't think that this Esha is the Esha of the Shruti. It is ayam of the Shruti, which as a